Hi, my name is Abel, and welcome to the DevOps Lab. On this episode, we have a very special guest, Dipendra. What are we going to be talking about this time?
In this episode, I'll be sharing some of the advanced Git capabilities of Wiki.
Awesome. Everybody, let's tune in. I'm super excited because this week we have a special guest, Dipendra.
Hi, I'm a UX designer with the Azure DevOps team. And today I'm going to share some of the advanced Git capabilities offered by the Azure DevOps Wiki.
Now, this is really, really important and special to me as a dev because as developers, we really want to use wikis a very specific way. Mm-hmm. A lot of times, we end up storing a lot of our documentation within our source control system all of our documents gets versioned right alongside our source code, right? So this is pretty common behavior of how developers behave. What can we do with Azure DevOps Wiki that helps with this type of workflow?
That's right. One of the things that we've observed talking to users is that a lot of developers actually prefer to manage the documentations right from within their IDE mm-hmm. instead of the browser.
Right.
And in a lot of scenarios, more often than not, like API documentation or SDK documentation, we observe that the code is stored in form of like markdown files right alongside the
source code.
The documentation is stored right alongside the source code in the code repository.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to show you and demonstrate that how do we enable some of these scenarios for developers.
Perfect. Let's see.
So one of the things is that since Wiki is actually powered by underlying Git repository,
okay,
it's possible for you to just head over here and clone the Wiki right into your IDE. And by doing so, you'll actually be able to edit all the Wiki pages just like you would edit any code files.
So you weren't kidding. I mean, literally, the Wiki is powered by a Git repo.
That's right. It's actually an underlying Git repository.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Okay. Show me more. I'm starting to get interested.
Sure. Another thing that we can do in here is that...
Okay. So this is your repository.
Yeah. This is my code repository.
Okay.
And right here, I've actually got a mix of like some code as well as some documentation.
Okay.
So, you know, there's this folder in which like I have like a bunch of markdown files.
Okay.
And then there's also like my code, which is source code, which is sitting right here in this repository.
So I do this all the time, right? I have my repo, I have mm-hmm. my source code right alongside it. I have a folder where I have my documents all laid out in markdown files, just like this.
Yeah.
All right. So what can I do with this?
Sure. So what we are going to do is that we are going to head over to Wiki.
Okay.
And we are going to click on Publish Code as Wiki.
Ah, okay. So this is where we use that Publish button.
That's right.
Okay.
So I'm going to select the relevant repository, the branch.
Okay.
And I select the folder, mm-hmm. which is going to be docs ref conceptual in this case.
Mm-hmm.
Let's give it a name, docs. And I'm going to publish it.
Nice.
Now what just happened is that Wiki actually scanned for all the markdown files in the code repository. And now those markdown files are being rendered here. It's important to note that we're not actually copying the markdown files into this, but they're still part of the code repository, and we're just like rendering them here. So any updates that happen to these markdown files in the code repository are gonna reflect automatically right here in the Wiki.
Nice. So I do have a question, though. I mean, this is great capabilities that we have creating these wikis directly in a Git repo, which is fantastic for me as a dev. How exactly do we version all of this stuff where it's easily consumable?
Sure. So all you got to do is to head over here. Mm-hmm. And as you can see that there's like the master branch.
Mm-hmm.
I can go ahead and actually publish an other branch from the repository.
Okay.
And I can use branches to actually manage my versioning needs.
Okay.
So let's go ahead and publish version 0.7
okay.
and click on update. Now, as I do that, it has actually published like version 0.7 right there.
Okay.
And this is how I can actually manage my versioning needs.
Very cool. So basically, let me just summarize quickly to make sure I understand.
Mm-hmm.
For every version, I can just take the master branch, create a branch, call it version XYZ, and publish that specific branch.
That's right. And any changes that would be part of those branches can be used as actually older versions or maybe different versions of what you're working on.
Very nice. Very cool. Mm-hmm. All right. What else can you show me?
Sure. So another thing is, so right now, as you publish these, they got rendered in a certain order. Mm-hmm. You also have the capability to be able to reorder these pages in a sequence that you would personally want.
OK, yeah, this is important. Yeah. How do we do that?
Sure. So what I'm going to do is head over to the code repository.
OK.
And you can also do that by clicking on Edit and Repos.
OK.
So right now, I'm actually looking at the same file within repos. Mm-hmm. Let's go back to the folder, which was docs ref conceptual.
Okay.
Let's create a new file over here. I'm going to call it the dot order file.
Okay.
So this is what you need to call it.
Okay.
And since I want, for this scenario, let's say I want node hyphen how to e2e on top.
Okay.
So I'm going to type it in.
So you just type in the title, correct?
That's right. You just type in the title.
Awesome.
And you save it.
And is it just one per line?
It's one per line, yeah. Okay. And whatever sequence you wanted, you just like go ahead and add those pages in the same sequence by the titles. Mm-hmm. And as you save it, it should automatically start reflecting in your wiki. So let's see if it worked. So as you can see right now, what happened is that node how to e2e just moved all the way up to top because we specified that order in the dot order file.
That seemed like a super easy way to figure out what the order, to specify what the order will be.
Right? That's right.
Just a dot order file in the repo and pray for that, you're done.
Yep.
Nice. All right, what else do you got?
So being able to search and get to the right information is really important when you're collaborating with your teammates.
Sure.
And that's where the wiki search kicks in. It's powered by Elasticsearch, which indexes everything that you type in.
Okay.
So let's give search a go.
Okay. So now you are searching your repository, right? And then it just pulls back and finds everything for you.
That's right. Yeah. So as I do that, I can see that it found out like various search results from the wiki, and then I also get to filter them if I'd like to. And here's what the search results look like.
So can I filter this down to like a specific, if I have multiple wikis, I can filter this down to one specific wiki?
That's right, yeah, you can do that.
Is there a finer grain, or is it that's just it?
As of now, it's just like down, you can just filter it down to the wiki level.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, super powerful stuff, and I love this, man. Once again, thank you so much for joining our show and sharing all this great information. As a developer, once again, this makes me happy because I am in Git all the time. Most of my stuff, I do it through there. Right?
That's right. And interestingly, since Wiki is powered by Git, possibilities are pretty endless. I mean, as developers, you might actually want a pull request flow to just make sure that you have some sort of control on whatever is being published. Mm-hmm. Or perhaps you need you have certain versioning requirements, and that's where all the Git capability helps you out.
Yeah, I can definitely see that, especially if we start using pull request capabilities and things like that inside of Git for our wiki pages. Awesome stuff. Thank you so much. Call to action. Go to dev.azure.com, start using Azure DevOps, start using the wikis, and give us feedback. Let us know what's great, let us know what's not great, so we can improve this product. So all you viewers out there, thank you so much for joining us this time. And next time, join us again on Azure DevOps Live.